Hey, it's Guy DiMartino. Today I want to discuss a few issues that I've recently come across with folks who have called up my office with concerns that family members have died in prison because of medical neglect or medical malpractice. As you know, I am a prison malpractice lawyer, and it's something strange about Florida. And we first have to go back and look at prisoners in general. Because folks go to prison, they lose some of their rights, and it's not the same thing that happens on the outside, what happens in prison. So this is what happens in the medical setting in prison. You can have two types of claims. The first type of claim would be a 1983 claim, which would be a deliberate indifference claim under the Eighth Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. And what the deliberate indifference claim looks at is whether there is a serious medical need and whether the medical provider actually appreciated the risk of the problem and did nothing. It's sort of like, I know that something is going on with you, I know that your condition is serious, but so what? The thing about the deliberate indifference standard is that it is so high. It is so high. It's much higher than the negligence standard, which is what a reasonable, prudent physician would do under similar circumstances. So in the deliberate indifference or constitutional law context, what we see here is we see providers saying and courts saying, well, the healthcare provider was negligent, but that's just not enough. So then we have the medical negligence issue, which is a state caught issue. But in the state of Florida, it works like this. It falls under the Wrongful Death Act. So if somebody dies because of medical negligence, the only way that a claim could be brought under the Wrongful Death Act is, number one, if they have a surviving spouse. And number two, if they don't have a surviving spouse, do they have a child that is 24 years old or younger? What we say is under the age of 25. So, if there's no surviving spouse and there's no children that are younger children, then there's no way to pursue a medical negligence claim. So then you're stuck with this constitutional standard, which is so much higher. So recently, I've looked at a number of cases where it was clear that the healthcare providers were negligent, and the person died in prison, and the person might have been getting out of prison very shortly, but they couldn't bring a claim because there was no surviving spouse or no dependent children under Florida's Wrongful Death Act. I know that this is unfair, but this is unfair for folks who are not in prison also. If you're on the outside and you go to your local hospital, the doctor or hospital is pretty much free to kill you and not give you the proper care if there's no surviving spouse and no dependent children. If you have any questions about a Florida prison death case, you can always give me a call. I am Guy DiMartino, meeting you at the intersection of law and medicine. Have a great day.